You know what's been coming up a lot lately? The difference between DRL and DRD, and I get the confusion. It's kind of described differently in different resources, which is for sure not helpful. In older resources, DRL is described as a procedure that reduces the rate of responding by setting a criteria of time between responses. That's basically an IRT criteria. Longer IRT between responses means fewer responses, and that's your lower rate, DRL, like reinforcing a response that occurs after 2 minutes or more. Now, in contrast, these sources claim that DRD decreases the rate by using a rate criteria, like reinforcing a behavior that occurs 3 times or less in a given period of time. Now, to me, what feels like a more current explanation is that the DRL procedure has 3 variations, spaced responding DRL, which is akin to that old school IRT criteria DRL that I just talked about, and full session and interval DRL. Full session means that a client must meet a predetermined rate criteria or less over an entire session. And interval DRL takes that full session, breaks it into smaller intervals of time during which the client must meet a predetermined rate criteria or less within this shorter interval of time. And this particular source, I'm looking at you, third edition white book, essentially likens the DRD procedure to a full session and interval DRL procedure. And I know what you're thinking. If they're the same thing, then why do we need all three? Well, because in my differential reinforcement travels, I've found other resources that add this. A DRD involves a gradually decreasing rate criteria that can even go to a 0 criteria, eliminating the behavior altogether, versus full session and or interval DRL is only meant to decrease it to at least 1 response and not eliminate it. Gosh, BCBAs, we need to know a lot of stuff. I really hope this helps.